Good afternoon, everybody. It's my pleasure to give a keynote lecture in the webinar today. I've been studying liquid crystal for more than 40 years. And today I'm going to talk about my major topics, polar liquid crystals. After the retirement from Tokyo Institute of Technology, I stayed 1 year in Germany, and then I joined the Toyota Physical and Chemical Research Laboratory as a research fellow, visiting fellow. During that time, I also stayed in many countries like Germany, Poland, and United States. Okay, let's start my presentation. First, I want to introduce briefly what is liquid crystals. Liquid crystal is the matter emerging between isotopic liquid and crystal. And the constituent molecule is anisotropic like rod or disc. And the rod-like molecular system, there are typically three different kinds of phases. One is pneumatic and symmetric A and symmetric C. In the pneumatic phase, there is only a orientational order without any positional order. However, in symmetrics, there is a layered structure. So it's a one-dimensional crystal and two-dimensional liquid. And symmetric A case, the molecule is perpendicular to the layer. And in the symmetric C, this is the tilted version of symmetric A. Okay, this is the outline of my talk. First, I want to explain how liquid crystal can have polar orders in such a fluidic system. And then I will explain several polar liquid crystalline phases which we discovered, namely antiferroelectric symmetric CA star and polar orders in bench-shaped molecular systems and ferroelectric pneumatic liquid crystals consisting of rigid rod polymers, and ferroelectric columnar liquid crystal consisting of conical molecule. Then finally, I will give you some message. Okay, ferroelectric material has the polarization, uniformly aligned polarization, and there are two important two necessary conditions, the sustainable polarization and switchable polarizations. And this single hysteresis loop is a manifestation of these two properties. Namely, polarization appears in zero field, and positive and negative polarization can be be switched by applying the positive and negative electric field. And antiferroelectric material shows the alternating polarizations like this. And by applying the field, uniformly aligned, the ferroelectric states appears. So we have this kind of double hysteresis loop. And the polarization is zero at a zero electric field. Okay, then the ferroelectric phase is more special. The neighboring polarization have different magnitude. So by changing electric field, the three, four states appears and triple hysteresis loop appears. Okay, you know that 32 crystal classes exist with different point symmetries. Among them, the only 10 of these, namely C1 to C6, and CS and C2V to C6V can show a ferroelectric or pyroelectric. So to have a ferroelectric liquid crystal material must have the symmetry of one of these. Okay, suppose we have a rod-like molecule which has a longitudinal dipole or transverse dipole. What happens is the enigmatic head and tail equivalence exists. So the polarization cancels and no polarization. And also we have a free rotation about long molecular axis. So also the polarization is canceled out. So we need some ideas to realize polar orders. These are the polar liquid crystalline structures so far discovered. The introduction of chirality can give two different kinds of ferroelectric phases. The in rod-like molecular case, this kind of chiral symmetric C star is the ferroelectric state. And this is the disc-like molecular version of this. And if molecule has dipole and molecule has the bent shape or conical shape, we may have a polarization along this direction because the bent shape prevent the free rotation. And also in conical molecular case, the conical molecule attacks the stacks to form a column. Then if molecule, the dipole can switches by applying the electric field, this is ferroelectric. Both are realized. And also rigid linear polymer can show a polar order, possibly because of dipole-dipole interaction. More recently, a new ferroelectric liquid crystal was discovered in these molecules. Even if small molecule, it shows ferroelectric switching. And the another group also shows the similar behavior, but polar structure is still under intense debate. So I will skip this story today. Okay, this is the historical overview of polar liquid crystals. In 1975, first ferroelectric liquid crystal symmetric sister was discovered. After 5 years, surface stabilization of this molecule opened the application to FLC displays. And since then, we discovered many type of polar liquid crystalline phase, such as symmetric CA star, antiferroelectric, and bent core symmetric C polar phase, and ferroelectric, polymeric ferroelectric liquid crystal, and columnar ferroelectric liquid crystals. And these color represent the different constituent molecule, like rod and disc and bent. Okay, let me start with the first liquid ferroelectric liquid crystal symmetric C star. Based on Bob Meyer's ideas, French chemist synthesized this molecule, which has the transverse dipole and chiral carbon. Unfortunately, this molecule shows the symmetric C star. Star means chiral. So the symmetry of C2H in C symmetric C is reduced to C2. So this is the candidate of ferroelectricity. And because of chirality, the tilt direction precesses from layer to layer to form the helical structure. Fortunately, they showed the polar switching in these molecules. The 5 years later, Clark and Lagerbaugh showed the surface stabilization. Namely, if the molecule material is introduced to thin cell, then helical structure is suppressed to show only two states with opposite polarization. And by applying an electric field, polarization is aligned and reversed by reversing field and so forth. Because of the first response and memory effect, ferroelectric liquid crystal display is very promising, and actually it was commercialized. Okay, then more than 10 years after the discovery of ferroelectric liquid crystal, we encountered the peculiar feature in the material named MHPOVC, which was studied to find new ferroelectric liquid crystals. This molecule shows this kind of behavior. Namely, this is the apparent tilt angle, molecular tilt, as a function of applied voltage. By changing the electric field from negative to positive, apparent tilt shows three stable states. And the tilt corresponds to the polarization. So this is exactly the same as the double hysteresis loop, which is characteristic of the antiferroelectric phase. 1 year later, we showed the model. Here in the stable state, molecule forms such kind of zigzag orientation, and by applying the field, in this state, there is no zero apparent tilt angle, but tilt appears positive or negative in this case by applying the field. This is far from the common sense of liquid crystal, because in liquid crystal phase, molecule want to be parallel to each other. However, this is not the case. That's why at that time, we did not know that we used the antiferroelectric phase when we discovered this behavior. In this paper, we also proposed the display application by applying a positive or negative voltage over the bias field. Then we can switch between these two positions. It corresponds to the transmittance changes. So this is the principle of the device application. Okay, the discovery of the antiferroelectric phase and the clarification of the structure was not the end of the story. Almost at the beginning, we also found several subphases. For instance, this is three layers periodicity and four layered periodicity. This is our Ising model, reported in 1991. Several years later, another model, Krupp model, was proposed by the resonance X-ray diffraction. However, this model cannot explain a large rotatory power. So we proposed another model using the optical measurement and some simulation. So this is the modified Ising model. And later, next year, the same group, resonance X-ray diffraction group, also the verified this model is correct. Okay, next topic is the bent-shaped molecule. Okay, this kind of bent-shaped molecule was synthesized by Volander quite a long time ago. And later, Matsunaga's group also synthesized more systematically. And they were interested in the liquid crystallinity, but not physical property so much. So their conclusion was this bent shape was not good for liquid crystals. The almost the same year, Bland et al. They proposed a possible polar structure by bent-shaped molecule like this. In 1993, Watanabe et al. Synthesized the bent-shaped dimers and bent core molecule like this, then gave them to us. We measured we confirmed the polar switching in this molecule and reported in Journal of Materials Chemistry. This paper was highly cited more than 1,000 times. And I also reported in the International Liquid Crystal Conference in Kent, USA. After my presentation, many liquid crystal scientists got into this field. This molecular system is interesting, not only from the viewpoint of polarity, but also from the chirality. Actually, even if the molecule is not chiral, the tilted layer becomes chiral. So these light-handed tilt and left-handed tilt layers are opposite chirality, has their opposite chirality. And nonlinear optics or chiral nonlinear optics effect and novel layer structures were also very interesting. And many phases have been identified so far like this. But of course, I have no time to explain all of these. So if you are interested, please refer to our book, Bent-Shaped Liquid Crystals, which was written by myself and Alexei Elemin. Okay, next topic is the polypeptide. We found that this molecule can show a ferroelectric response. This molecule forms the alpha helix, which is stabilized by hydrogen bonding. And also, because of this rigid structure, we have a huge dipole moment along this the long chain, 4 dBi times degree of polymerization. Okay, the aromatic polyester is another example. In this case, we use a second harmonic generation to probe the polar order because SHG is active only when the system has no center symmetry. Okay, when the degree of polymerization is small, SHG is inactive because the head and tail equivalence exists. With increasing the degree of polymerization, the SHG spontaneously increases. This shows that the dipole, larger dipole, tend to align spontaneously to a particular direction. So this is important result. The naive consideration can be made based on this theoretical paper. We know that dipole tend to be antiparallel to each other. However, this the relation, dipole relationship is more stable. So if you think about a rigid rod with a series of point dipoles, then a line of electric force goes like this. So this kind of positional relationship is not possible, is not easy to be formed. However, this is possible because the electric force goes this way. So this is the naive consideration. Actually, these authors said that ferroelectric ordering is more likely to occur in nematic polymers and with dielectric polar segment than in low molecular weight nematic liquid crystals composed of polar molecules. Okay, finally, this is the last example, just briefly, the ferroelectric columnar liquid crystal. In this case, we designed this kind of conical shape, and this conical molecule forms this kind of columns, and the polarization is aligned to form this kind of ferroelectric state. By applying the field, this kind of switching motion occurs. The importance of this, the liquid crystal phase, is the possible application to high density memory devices, which amount to 40 terabyte per square inch meters. By using the such kind of tip, we can switch the each columns like this. So the preliminary experiment is very promising. Okay, I'm almost the end of my talk. I explained several the polar phases which we discovered before. The most important one is the antiferroelectric phase and bench-shaped mesogens. In both cases, the many scientists encounter these molecules and study. However, they did not reach the final goal of interesting fact. This is because in both cases, it's far from the common sense of liquid crystal. The people believe that the molecule want to be parallel to each other. However, liquid crystal molecules do not necessarily align parallel to each other in a zigzag fashion. And in this case, the bent-shaped molecules were believed not to be suitable for a liquid crystal. However, actually, this molecule are treasure trove of liquid crystal science. So this is the message, particularly to young scientists. Discarding conventional wisdom is sometimes the first step toward attaining new understanding. We are still under pandemic, unfortunately, due to COVID-19. But there is a good news. In 17th centuries, Isaac Newton, when he was 23 years old, discovered the universal law of gravitation during his evacuation life from plague epidemic. In this 1.5 year, he also achieved two important works of differential and integral calculus and optics. So final message to you is please stay safe and think deeply. Thank you very much for your attention.